Hi, welcome to a Creo 4 video tutorial. I've downloaded a 30-day trial version of this program, so I thought it might be a good idea to do some Creo 4 video tutorials. And I want to do one of my favorite exercises, that housing, which I did almost in all the other programs. So let's try to have some fun with Creo. Sadly, I couldn't find or couldn't achieve to turn it into an English version, so I will do it with a German version. Okay, let's start with a sketch, maybe on the front plane. So maybe I should make them visible, would be a good idea. So I want to do a sketch right there, and that would be a circle. So if you want to give it a dimension, select it and then press the middle mouse button. That's sort of crazy, but that's Creo. And that one would be 38. Then confirm that sketch and make an extrusion. So go to model, profile, and it should be symmetric, and the distance should be 33.5. So I made a slight mistake in that sketch, so change it. That's not the diameter but the radius. So go for 19 as radius and it will work. Yes. Now I need a plane parallel to this one with a distance. So go for plane, select that one. The translation would be 33.5 divided by 2. And confirm. Now let's do a sketch on that plane. That should be a rectangle. Maybe like this. Give it dimensions. This would be 8. And this would be 38. The distance from that line to that plane would be 19, and if you want to do it symmetric you need a center line. So go for a center line, maybe like this. Okay, and then you could do symmetry point line, and okay. Now let's do an extrude, change direction, make it 10, confirm, fillet 4, select edge, that edge, this edge, and of course this edge. And confirm. Nice. Now I will do a pattern, a geometry pattern with that profile. Go for direction, select the direction that would be the set direction, and turn it around two instances. And the distance should be 23.5. And the second direction would be the y direction. Turn it around two instances and the distance would be 30. And confirm. Now let's pattern that fillet. Make it reference and use as reference this pattern. and confirm, and OK. Nice. Next sketch would be on the top plane. So select top plane, go for a sketch. And that's another circle. And the radius is 16. Confirm. Now I would need another plane with a distance to the top plane. So go for a select top plane, go for another plane, and the distance would be 67.5. Confirm. Now I want to make an extrude with that sketch. And I don't want to cut. I want it to extrude up to that plane and confirm. Now another sketch on that plane. Another circle. And the radius would be 43 divided by 2. Confirm. Let's make another extrude with that sketch. Turn it around. Distance is 1.5. And confirm. Now a pattern. I want to pattern this one along a direction, and the direction would be the y direction. Turn it around. I need 8 instances, and the distance would be 3 millimeter. And pretty nice. So maybe I do the next on the top as well. Another sketch right there. Another circle, a small one. And that should be 7. No, 3.5. Okay, this should be vertical aligned, that point to this point, if possible, or just put this point right on that axis, and the distance from this one to that point is 19. Nope, it's not 19, but what's the distance? 17. Yes. Okay. Another extrude with that sketch. Turn it around. And no, it should not go for cut. And that would be 8. Confirm. Now I want to make a circular pattern with that profile. need an axis, and the axis would be the y-axis. Okay, and I want to have 7, not 7 but 6. And the angle should be 360 degrees. And confirm. Very nice. So another sketch now on the right plane or the front plane. This one. It's the right plane. Oh, seems there's something off. So that's not centered. So I will check this. But first, another rectangle. Maybe like this. That distance should be 60. That distance should be 6. And it should be symmetric. So let's do a center line. Maybe like this. Doesn't matter. And make it symmetric. So this point and that point should be symmetric to that line. Okay. Now make another extrude. Make it symmetric and 33.5 and confirm. So this is off, and that was not profile 1 but profile 2. So I have to change profile 2, the sketch. This sketch should be changed. Yeah, it's off. Delete that one. Make a new center line. Okay. Then make symmetry. This point and that point should be symmetric to that line. And confirm. This looks pretty good. Next sketch on the top plane. Therefore, I need a circle. And the diameter or the radius should be 21.5, 21.5, and the rectangle, maybe like this, and this point on that line should be centered, the distance should be 26. Now let's trim. Yep. And confirm and make another extrude with that sketch. Don't cut, and the distance should be 44. And confirm. Now I want to have a fill it on this edge and that edge. And that should be 5. Let's see if it works. Not quite, because it goes doesn't go through. So maybe I should do that, fill it in the sketch, change that sketch and make a fillet. Here and there. Give it a dimension. This should be 5 and this should be 5 as well. Confirm. That's more like it. And another fillet on that edge, 5, and confirm. So I think I've created all the material I need. Now I can start to remove material. It would be great to reuse some of those sketches somehow. So let's go for our first sketch, that sketch. Copy it and just Control V, paste it there. Okay, now change that sketch, or you could just edit the parameters, and this would be not 19 but 16. Okay. Now let's do with that sketch, in this case a cut, and make it symmetric or through all on both sides and confirm. Nice. Then I could reuse that sketch 3, yes, so copy and paste it right there. Control V. Confirm and show the parameters on this. Should not be 16 but 13.5. Okay, and let's make another extrude with that sketch. Should be a cut and it should go up to that plane or through all. So through all, confirm. Now I want to reuse another sketch, not this one but that one. So copy it and just paste it up there. Control V and confirm. Edit the parameters, and this would be 1.5. Make another extrude and make it a cut. And it should be 5 with that profile and confirm. Now circle a pattern select this one, pattern, reference. There is no reference, there's just, no, I go to axis, and then it would be the y-axis. Yes, 6 instances equally distributed with 360 degrees, and confirm. Very nice indeed. Oh, I missed something. I forgot something. Okay, so I want to move this up, maybe up to that one. Oh, yeah. I need another sketch. Now on this plane. On right plane. On this one. That's sort of not ideal because I cannot see, so I should move this here after that one. Yeah. And now do the sketch on that plane. That would be a rectangle, and this should be -49. That distance should be 11. And it should be centered, and there should be a distance. There should be a distance from this line to that one, and that should be 41 minus 5.5. Yep. Then I need a center line. Okay, now make it symmetric, this point to that line right here, and okay. So let's see if I can make the fillets after all, or I have to go for the sketch fillets. So let's make a extrusion with that sketch, turn it around. And the distance should be 26. And confirm. So if I try to do the fillets right here, just that would be 5.5. But I think this will not work, at least not. Yeah. So I should go to the sketch and do it in the sketch. Make the fillets. Here. And here. Make this one 5.5. And this one 5.5 as well. leave that sketch. Yeah, and I could do, that's not, again, it's not symmetric. I'm missing something, obviously. So let's go for this fillet right here and that fillet right there. Confirm. So this one wasn't 5.5. I thought I did it 5.5. Crazy. That's that sketch right here. Check the parameters. And maybe, yeah, that's 5.5. Oh, in this case it's diameter. Yeah, that's okay. Now let's move this to the end. Not possible. Why? Okay. I had to end the insert mode. Okay, what can I reuse next? That sketch. Not quite. So maybe I should go for a new sketch. Yeah. So there should be a new sketch on that plane. Again, a rectangle. This time it's eight, and that distance is 26, and it should be symmetric to for a center line. Make this one symmetric to that center line, and another distance from that line to this one. And that should be 41 minus 4, that's 37. Nope. That's 41 minus 4. That's 37. So that distance is usually 41 to the center. Now I did the upper line. So it's 45. Yeah. Now let's do an extrude with that sketch. Turn it around, make it a cut. And okay. Then I need another plane with a distance to that one, and the distance should be 6. And I want to reuse that sketch. Okay, I want to reuse a sketch, and I think I have to delete that fillet. So maybe I should delete that fillet. And that was this fillet. Okay, then I want to reuse that sketch somehow. Yeah, so let's go for copy and paste it on that plane. plane, control V, and let's see, maybe I have to change the orientation. Let's take a look. No, that's okay. Put it right there. Now change that to 3.5. This one to 3.5. That one to 20. This one to 23. Then put that point on this one and the same point right there on that one and confirm. Now I can make a cut. So go for profile, cut, and the distance would be 36.5, and confirm. Now let's do the fillet right there with 3.5. Fillet right on this edge, and that should be 3.5. Confirm, and then that fillet. With 5 and confirm. That's nice. So what's missing? All those holes. Okay, maybe I start right here. So let's go for hole, and the diameter of these holes would be 3. And the depth in this case 3 as well. Okay. And I want to put it right there. And that's another strange thing. You have those two, select that as reference and select this one as reference. And that distance would be, I think that's 15 or 16. 15. And the other one is 15 as well. And confirm. Now I need a pattern. So I want to pattern that hole circular. Go for axis, and that would be this axis, and I need 4 distributed equally on 360 degrees, and confirm. So, where is it? There should be, I don't see it. Nope. Let's make the same over here, right here. Again, this is reference, that is reference, 15 and 15, confirm, another pattern with this one. Oh, there it is. So let's delete this. I wanted to mirror it and I didn't see it. So I want to mirror that pattern, mirror it, and the mirror plane would be this one, and confirm. Nice. Then there is a hole over here, right there, and use as reference maybe that edge and maybe this edge. So that distance, nope. Once again, hole right there. It's really hard to see, so use that as reference and this one as reference. And this would be 5.5. And that might be, that's 13, and altogether it's 49, so it's that's 24.5 minus, oh, that's really hard to calculate. That's 26. So the difference is 23 divided by 2. Maybe I could move this to the other edge, maybe over here. Ah, that doesn't work. So maybe I go to the center. That's better. Yeah. And that distance would be 19. Yeah. And confirm. And I could mirror this one as well. So go for mirror, and the mirror plane is this one. Confirm. Nice. Now another pattern on that face, so maybe I should hide those planes. I need another hole right there. This should go up to the next one and use as reference. Yeah, so I should show the planes again. And the distance to center plane and the distance to that center plane. This should be 55 divided by 2, and this one should be 13. Yeah, confirm. Let's do a pattern with that whole pattern with a direction. First direction would be this one, turn it around two instances, and the distance would be 55. Next one would be in that direction, 2, and the distance would be 25. And confirm. Yeah. And I'm done. So if you want to see more, or if you liked it, please give it a like or leave a comment. If you want to see more Creo, please give it a like, leave a comment. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe to my Facebook cat fan page. Would be very nice of you. And please like it. Please, please, please. Thanks for watching. See you to the next one. Bye bye.